What's up, guys? Welcome back to Travel and Fun. Here is another video, and this is a very important video. Yeah. And this will be of very prime importance to those who are coming to
Denmark.
I mean, fresh comers, newcomers, yeah.
So those like
who
us.
Are, yeah, like us. So who are coming, who are migrating to Denmark from India or wherever you are coming from? This is a very important video. So this video is about
home search.
Yes.
Like when you come to Denmark, you guys have to settle down. So home search is a very, you know, priority thing you want to do. So this video is about our points we made during the home search, and these points are purely personal. This is only our points, and it has nothing to do with the normal general stuff. And one more thing you have to keep in mind, that there are scams going on in Denmark. Like if you're searching for homes, please go to some reputed websites or housing agency or company to get your homes. Don't go through Facebook subs and all.
Yeah.
And if you're going, please make sure that the house owner is, or the landlord is,
it's legit. Yeah.
Legit, yeah.
And don't pay anything forehand, you know. Don't go for payments.
Make a contract for
exactly
even one penny you're paying.
Yeah, exactly. So you can refer to websites like Heimstad and
Bolig
Hotel,
Achilles,
and there are so many websites.
Find more websites.
Yeah, so many websites where you can find homes. There are also communal housing agencies here where you can register yourself. Then there are wait listing and all, and you can wait for a good home in a very good
but
budget.
But it takes time.
Yeah, that will take time. So normally people who come here, they, especially ones who come with family, they look for rental homes that come in their budget. You know, that fit all of their criteria. So it's always good to have some points to keep in mind while you're looking for homes here.
And one more thing you have to make sure is your home should be able to register your CPR number.
Yeah.
And it is very essential.
Yeah, the CPR is the central person's register here. So central people register. So the CPR number is very unique. And normally you shouldn't share it with anyone going on the road or someone. So that's not happening here. You shouldn't do that. But normally whenever you have to register somewhere on websites and all, you might have to give your CPR number. So you have something
and
also.
Number will have all your information.
Yeah.
Like your doctor and everything is connected here.
Yeah. So all of these are connected, and so this video about home search, and we hope that you will like it. So let's get into some of the points that we prefer to while looking for homes. Yeah.
For this renting a house, our first and foremost priority was fixing a budget for our rent. Okay. So since we are new here and we need time to settle down, Deepak initially gave me a budget of 8,000 crores, and we were searching home with this 8,000 crores, and finally we came to a situation like we are not going to get any house in 8,000 crores. So we had to increase our budget. We didn't have any other options. So we increased our budget again 3,000 more to 11,000 crores. But we thought we should include the utilities also in that 11,000 crores. Because in Copenhagen, the houses with nominal rates, no, they sell up like hotcakes. You won't get houses. Even like big websites like Heimstad and Bolig Portal, those house owners, before even replying to us, they'll mark it as rented out. So you're not going to get houses like very easily. So we thought we should run and we should take time in finding this house search. My next criteria was supermarkets or grocery stores. This was my own requirement because I always prefer to have a grocery store or a supermarket nearby. Now he's working from home, but if he's again going to office daily, then I cannot ask him like take me to shop daily, you know, so it will not be good. So if I want something, the shop should be in such close radius that I can go and purchase it of myself. And if I feel bored or something, I can go out myself. And Denmark is very safe, so you can go out without even worrying about anything. Next was also my personal criteria. Like I always wanted an open kitchen, and I don't like kitchen to be in some other different secluded place in a home. I feel like I'm in a different island and I'm not connected with the house. So I always wanted an open kitchen, and I also wanted a balcony because I want my house to be very bright and ventilated. I don't like closed places. So this was my condition. Like it was not a condition, it was my wish, like I want open kitchen and balcony, and I was okay if it was not possible also. The next criteria was white goods. White goods means like all the fridge, dishwasher and your cooking setup, cooking range and your washing machines. And sometimes that includes your cupboards as well. That depends on the house owner, like what they are providing. We searched for this white goods very much because we wanted this dishwasher and washing machine, because last time when we were in Germany, we didn't have dishwasher and washing machine, and we were using water, like enough and more water, and after 1 year, after returning back to India, we had to pay a huge amount for this water and heating tax. So this time I thought, no, we'll go for washing machine and dishwasher so that we can save that money.
So our next point was about the bathroom. Yes, it might feel silly, but yes, this is a very important point for us. Especially when we came to Copenhagen, in this company provided temporary accommodation, we came to know that bathrooms here are really very small. Even when I got the options from my company about the three home options that I got from the company, all the bathrooms were quite very small, especially the ones in this Copenhagen area. The thing is, you don't even have space to stand and shower, you know. They're really compact. The bathrooms are very small and they lack space actually. The reason behind this is because these are all old buildings here in Copenhagen, and they really didn't have bathrooms during the earlier times. So what they have done is that when they modernized the apartments, they just put in a small bathroom cabin inside with some shower cabin. That's it. So you just have the pot and the wash basin and just hardly any place to stand and shower. That's why our foremost criteria, one of the foremost criteria, was having a good big bathroom. And moreover, we like our bathroom to be dry, so it's always better to have a different shower place, you know, inside the bathroom, so that you can keep the bathroom dry and clean. Our next point was having a laundry setup. Laundry setup, you mean the washing machine and the dryer. So when I was a bachelor, it was okay for me. I mean, I didn't prefer, but there were bachelors who preferred having common laundries. In that way, you can save water bills, you can save electricity bills. So this is the way you save money when you are a bachelor. So you use the common laundries. But now, since we are a family, and especially both of us, we don't like common laundries. And it's purely a personal preference. It's not because it's not hygienic and stuff. They are very good here. I mean, I have seen in Germany also here that there are good common laundries. You get your clothes washed and cleaned and dried at a very nominal price. But we personally don't prefer it. Moreover, all the points that we put here are purely our personal choices and preferences. These can change according to your choices. So our next requirement or criteria was accessibility. No doubt that the public transport system in Copenhagen is in very good shape. It's amazing. You have good provisions of city buses, S trains, metros, even the bicycling is amazing. You have bicycling lanes here, and Copenhagen is one of the best known cities for bicycling. But we preferred being close to public transport stations, at least a bus station, so that it's easy for you to get to the city center or something in case you don't have the mood to ride a bicycle or so. So that's why our preference was being close to a bus station. Either of them, we don't want all of them all together, and not that get down and have a bus stop, no, at least within a 5 minutes walk distance. So that's why, since the home we are looking into now is away from the city center, so it's always good to have a public transport system close to us. So our next criteria was the area of the house itself. Yes, this is as I told about the bathroom, you know, so bathrooms are quite small. The same way, if you go for area, if you look into like apartments within 30 to 40 square meters range, they are really small. Actually, I didn't have a very good idea about the square meters size, how big it would be, because in India, we normally are used to square feet, okay? So here it's 30 to 40 square meters, and we were initially looking for studio apartments also, you know, so that we get it in a good budget range. But then eventually we went to some open houses and stuff where the area was like 36, 39 square meters, and it was really cramped. You know, the area was so small you, it feels like you don't have space to breathe. So that's why area was one of the very big criteria that we had. At least for two of us, we thought that we should have at least a home rental place which should be around 50 to 60 square meters. And yes, 50 to 60 square meters is quite good for a couple, or even with one child, it's quite good. So here the room concept is a little different, you know, like, so if you say it's a two room apartment, it's like a one hall and one bedroom. So your home will have one hall and one bedroom. And if it's one room, you just have one room, a kitchen and bathroom. That's it. So you have to be very careful about these things when you look into these websites and web portals searching for homes. So yes, that is why area was a very prime criteria for us looking for homes.
So guys, we hope you guys liked this video and at least some points were of good information for you guys.
Yes, and we will come up with good videos like this, and do let us know if you want a detailed video of what points should you take care of when you're renting a home. You know, there are a lot of points that you have to take care. So we will make a video if we have enough comments for that video, and if we have good number of views and subscribers with this video, and that will be a very important, you know, that is of prime importance, that you have to know what you have to keep in mind. Yeah. When you are renting a home, okay, there are a lot of points to keep
there
in mind.
There are a lot of points, like we have mentioned only 5 or 6 points here, and if we want to count, there are more than 20-30 points you have to keep in mind when you are renting an apartment in Denmark.
Yes, especially when you are renting an apartment and then you have to give it back, you know, when you move on to a new apartment or your own apartment. So it's very essential that you know those points. So we'll cover that in a different video. Make sure you like, share and subscribe, and let us know if you want that video. And hope you guys are liking our videos. If you like our videos, don't forget to click that subscribe button, because what we see in the YouTube Studio analytics is that almost 70-80% of the traffic are people who are not subscribed. So it doesn't cost you even a penny to just push the subscribe button,
and that will be a biggest motivation for us.
Exactly. And make sure you like and comment whatever you have, whether it be a negative comment or a positive comment. So negative comments will be taken up for improvements, and positive comments will make us and you happy, and we are happy to be a family with you all. So with this good note, we end this video.
We are signing off.
Yeah.
And
until the next video.
Next video, it's bye from us.
Bye-bye.